about just to come into contact with ourselves and to welcome ourselves into this space. And then we'll have some walking meditation before lunch. And this afternoon we'll talk a bit more about cultivating the beautiful, uplifting emotions. Are you all okay with the sound? I'm doing my best to speak up, but... Are you all okay? Is anyone not okay with the sound? There's a lot more space at the front, and I don't have coronavirus. So I'll give a little bit of guidance during this meditation session. But whatever I offer during these sessions is just an invitation. So if you want to continue to practice in your own way, that's perfectly fine. You can just let the words drift over your head or pick up anything that's helpful. So it's important to find a comfortable position to begin the meditation. A position that's right for your body at this moment. So really listen in and allow your body to give feedback on how it would like to sit or stand. So just gently running through the body with your mind. Just taking in the generalized posture, the way you've positioned your feet, your ankles. Whether your knees are comfortable or the weight is a little bit too heavy on your knees. If you're on a chair, you may wish to just put your ankles maybe even half an inch forward from your knees so that you release any strain on the knee. If you're seated, sometimes the ankles or the heels can be pressing on one another. So see if you can give them a little bit more space. Checking the way that the weight's distributed between your thighs, your buttocks. Whether anything is pinching. Noticing your spine. Maybe gently inviting your spine to lengthen just a little bit. You might want to check the angle of your spine. You can gently roll forward and back a little. and really find the optimum position that brings a feeling of release, space, looseness, whilst maintaining that uprightness. Just this much is an act of care for the body. Noticing that shoulder area, often the area we carry a lot of tension and tightness. Just noticing if your shoulders are scrunched up at all or leaning forward, maybe pulled too tightly back. And you might want to experiment with the position of your hands to see if they need adjusting in order to bring your shoulders that bit more space. Noticing the neck, the area where the neck meets the head. And seeing if you can sense the space between the last vertebra and your skull area. And just allowing the head to really relax in the confidence that it's held, it's supported by the spine. Allowing your facial muscles to relax. Checking your throat, your jaw. Gently inviting that to let go of any tension. Now to begin the meditation, I'd like to suggest that we imagine we're held in the loving gaze of somebody with whom we feel very safe. It may be the gaze of a benevolent Buddha. Maybe a parent or a friend. Someone who sees the best in you, who understands you without judgment. Who looks upon you with kindly eyes. Whether real or imagined, how does that feel? If it's difficult to imagine this happening in the presence of another, you may prefer to imagine that you're in a beautiful place in nature. Maybe there's a soft, warm sun shining upon you. A gentle breeze through the trees. You feel at one with life. Safe. Protected. And at ease. Not needing to be anyone. No one measuring you. And no need to get anywhere other than more fully where you already are. So just lingering in this perception. Now we're going to bring the same loving gaze to our own body, starting from the head and just contacting any sensation on the top of the head. With an open-hearted curiosity, an attitude of friendliness and warmth, as you allow your awareness to spread and explore any sensation in the head area. Using these two aspects, the mindfulness, which is like the light of the sun, and the kindness, which is like the warmth of the sun. As you spread your awareness through the face, down the neck, to the shoulder area, noticing any experience, any sensation. And regarding all those experiences with kindly eyes. Giving them space. Very naturally, in your own time, keep on spreading this loving awareness through the body, down the arms, to the elbows, neglecting no area, noticing the armpits, the size of the body, the rib cage. including everything in this experience. Being a host to all the sensations, emotions, moods or thoughts you encounter. Exploring the whole torso, the chest, the tummy area, the back, the lower back, maybe even inside the body. Without looking for any special sensation. Maybe areas with no particular sensation. But just maintaining this curiosity, friendliness and respect. If you come across any areas which feel tight or tense or maybe connected with an emotion that you find difficult, see if you can adjust your awareness. Maybe give it a bit more space. Noticing the edges of that sensation, where that sensation comes to an end. Maybe passing over it just on the surface of the body. Or if your mind feels quite clear, strong, you may want to explore inside the body. Or in the middle of that emotion. Just respect your own limitation. What feels good for you? And keep on checking how you're relating to your experience. Aware of sensations in the lower parts of the body, the buttocks, the thighs, maybe heaviness, numbness, tightness. Maybe throbbing, pulsing, tingling sensation. See if if you can give your caring attention to your thighs. Noticing how your attention helps to relax and soften your experience. Coming to your knee area. Sometimes a lot is going on in the knees. Notice if your attention gets pulled into any areas of tightness. Whether you're reacting with negativity, with worry, and just see if you can gently relax the way you relate. Give any difficult sensations space to be there. And massage them with kindness. If you need to move at any point, just do so out of compassion. Knowing the purpose of why you need to adjust. Finding that space between the experience and your response. Spreading your kind awareness, the light and the warmth of the sun, all the way down the legs to the ankles. Often we neglect our feet, never really notice what's happening down there. So see if you can notice sensations in your soles, maybe the sides of the feet, the bridge of the foot. Noticing each and every toe. And seeing what kind of attention is needed to just relax those toes. when you feel you've spread your awareness through the whole body, just check how your body feels now. And if there are any areas of tightness or tension, any areas maybe that you want to give a bit more exploration to, allow your awareness to flow there. Learning how to meet experience without clinging or holding on. Whatever sensation, emotion, or thought pattern you may be experiencing, keep on relating to this with kindly eyes, with an attitude of acceptance, understanding and warmth. Realizing no experience belongs to me, just nature doing its thing. Not me, not mine, not a self. coming close to the end of the meditation session, before you open your eyes, just reflect on your experience. Were you able to be a host to all your emotions, the feelings and the thoughts? And meet them with understanding, with friendliness. What kind of emotions were you more able to be at ease with? Did you notice if there was a movement to push away or to roll in the emotions? And what kinds of thoughts and attitudes may have been underneath those conditioned responses? There's no wrong or right experience, but just looking and understanding the way we work means that every meditation is an opportunity for insight to arise. So I'll ring the bell, and at the end of the third ringing, you can open your eyes to come out of the meditation. Good. It's dangerous business. Exploring the world of the angle of microphones during that meditation. Anyway, so now is the opportunity for continuing your practice in the walking posture if you wish. You're always welcome to stay here and continue to meditate as well. So the schedule is just a guideline. It's not something fixed that you have to follow. I'm not checking on you or seeing what you're up to. So even if you want to lie down in here, I don't mind. I know that many of you are probably tired after a busy week. But the invitation is to try the walking meditation. Is there anyone here who hasn't done walking meditation before? Yeah? Just a couple. So actually none of you have done it before, you all think you have, but every step is a new step. So we try and meet every experience and every practice with a beginner's mind, a mind of open curiosity. So the walking offers a really nice contrast to the sitting meditation. It's not just a fill-in sort of a period where you can get a cup of tea and all the rest. It's actually a really important part of practice, and it gives the mind an opportunity to increase its agility, to increase this flexibility, to be able to bring that open friendly awareness to your experience, no matter what you're doing. So it can be very helpful to get familiar with the walking so that you can bring it into your everyday life, you know, into all those in-between moments where you're going from your home to the train station or just to the car, you know, or you're running around the house trying to find something. You can bring your attention to your feet and to your legs. So here in meditation, we're going to do the traditional kind of walking where we choose a certain area of grass, or I guess it's mostly grass. There's some areas which are under, what do you call those places?
Awnings.
Under the awnings. But it's not raining, so you might want to be in the fresh air. And you just choose a certain length, maybe about 10 or 15 steps long. And we're just going to walk from one end to the other. And the idea is to learn to arrive in every step. And also to notice what each step is comprised of. Because in every single step, there are a lot of different movements. And with each movement of the foot, you'll experience different sensations. So we're bringing our awareness into the feet and exploring the feet and how they move and how they feel. So how they feel when you lift them. There's maybe a sensation of lightness. And then how they meet the ground, which part of the foot meets the ground first. What kind of experience is there? Maybe you feel the weight in the foot and how it moves into the foot as you shift your weight onto it. Yeah? Probably in this weather you won't want to take your shoes off, so it's not quite as interesting as walking barefoot, but you'll find there's a lot there in each step. And so just remember to maintain an attitude of relaxation and openness with the walking. Sometimes we can become a bit tight, especially if we start to walk slowly. So take an ordinary speed, and you'll find that when the mind becomes calm with the walking, you'll probably naturally slow down. But every time, just from time to time, take a kind of bird's eye view and notice if your body's become tense or if you're trying too hard, and just relax. Yeah? Sometimes people's minds are not able to stay with something as small as one foot, so you might want to take a bigger piece of the body, maybe the whole leg, or maybe the whole body even as it moves. So just explore again with this space, you know, how spacious do you want your attention to be, and also with the way you're relating to the experience of walking. Yeah? So just bringing that inquisitive, gentle friendliness to the walking experience. Yeah? Good. And then I think for you, lunch will be about 12 o'clock. So if, is it Laura?
It's
Kate, sorry. Kate could ring the bell at 12 o'clock. That would be lovely. And I'll have my food now and meet you back here at 1 o'clock. So please enjoy the walking. And after lunch, take your time. You know, you'll have probably a good half hour of free time to continue the practice. So just make this practice and this day about the way you're relating to your inner world, and see if you can just bring a bit more kindness to that. See what happens.